Now, we've got some interesting moves over the past few weeks. The majority, though, have been loan deals. The coronavirus pandemic has had a huge impact on teams across the world. However, we've picked out our best deals of the window so far. OK, Ade, we'll go with you first, then Mark, then me. Who do you think's been the best deal so far, Ade?
Hands down, Martin Odegaard has to be.
He hasn't played yet.
It's a win-win. He's gonna tick all the boxes, trust me. Look, no obligation to buy, no option to buy. Arsenal obviously cover his wages, which we believe are in the region around £38,000 a week, which, let's be honest, for a player of his ilk, isn't too much. I mean, spent last season on loan at Real Sociedad, 7 goals, 9 assists. The season before that was in the Eredivisie with Vitesse, 11 goals, 12 assists. Exactly what Arsenal need, an attacking midfielder who can score, who can assist. I think it's fantastic for Arsenal. Look, one thing they have lacked, when you look at that midfield, I look at it, and I like Arsenal's team. I do. I like the balance so far. But look at the midfield. Xhaka, Partey, Elneny as the main focal points in that midfield. All ball winners. Partey can definitely do a bit more. Those are hard-working ball winners. Where's the creativity? The creativity is with Emil Smith Rowe. He's a youngster. I don't think Arsenal want to put everything on him. There's no way that Mikel Arteta would have started this season thinking that Emil Smith Rowe is going to be the main man. He's going to carry the burden. I think Martin Odegaard comes in, helps carry that burden, helps Bukayo Saka as well. And I don't think they've got enough from Willian. I think that's disappointing, a return of no goals whatsoever. And let's not forget as well, Pierre-Emerick Aubameyang was their talisman for so many years, always relied on him for goals. Just the 8 goals this season, obviously out now with family personal issues. They're going to need to spread those goals around that team now. They really want to push on and get into a European spot. This guy can score, he can assist. Yes, Mark's right, he hasn't played so far, but trust me, he was a wonder kid many years ago, and he's going to do wonderful things for Arsenal.
No. He did come off the bench on Saturday, didn't
yes.
he? We weren't able to see much of him. Mark, I actually can't remember who you chose, and given that you've been frantically going through your notes, you might have forgotten as well.
You know what, it's one of those things that when it got confirmed by Manchester United that they'd signed this man, Amad Diallo, I got really excited, and he was...
Hasn't played for United this season, has he?
Yeah, no, he hasn't, you're right.
Good point.
But it was one of those, I spoke to a number of people actually that had watched him play over in Italy, told me a little bit about his background and the fascinating story that had brought him over to the Premier League, that had even taken him to Italy in the first place, and it's been written about and discussed. And then I just made note after note after note after note. The more people I spoke to about the player, the more excited I got, and the more research I did, the more excited I got. And I just made like a whole page of notes here to talk about Amad Diallo and how he potentially could be, a future world footballing superstar. I even congratulated Manchester United and Ed Woodward for the business they'd done. Let's be honest, the black and white facts are the fee could rise to £37 million. Mm. I think that says all you need to know about the type of player that Manchester United feel they're getting, that they're willing to invest someone that's played very little first-team football. But he's come out of that very famous Atalanta academy that's been producing players for world football for in excess of 30 or 40 years. He's a right winger, left-footed. He's got brilliant balance. He could probably play as that sort of left-footed inside forward, which is the Mo Salah type of role. He's got all the makings, all the qualities, a great temperament as well. And he wants to be on the ball. He wants to make things happen. The fact that Manchester United had brought this loan forward to bring him into the club now, I think says all you need to know. They weren't happy with him being out on loan, playing his football somewhere else. They could have brought him over to Old Trafford in the summer. They've gone, no. We want him now. We want him in training now. And I think he's going to have a huge impact on Manchester United for the second phase of the season. He's the player I'm excited about. I like Odegaard, but this kid is a future superstar. And I think maybe 5 years' time, he'll be right up there with some of the best players in world football.
So your player hasn't played yet. Yours has come on as a sub. Well, mine's only played once as well.
Right? What do we know?
So I've gone for Mbaye Diagne, who West Brom have signed on loan with an option to buy. The reason I've gone for him, and I didn't know too much about him before. I've done a lot of research on him now. But he played on Saturday. He looked very dangerous. Yeah. He got an assist as well, a very good assist. But if you look at his career, he has been prolific throughout. He actually signed for Juventus in 2013. Didn't really get a game there. He was young at the time, didn't get a chance. He was loaned out a lot. But if you look at his previous clubs, he was at Club Bruges briefly, 4 goals in 6 games. Galatasaray, tough league, 19 goals in 30 games. Kasimpasa, 32 goals in 34 games, and Tianjin Teda, 16 goals in 44 games. He also got 11 in 14 at the club before that. He has scored goals everywhere that he's gone, and he did really well on Saturday for West Brom. And mainly, though, it's because Sam Allardyce has got such a brilliant record at signing players in January. You know I love him, Addy. That's why you're laughing.
But I know. I just looked at Mark.
I can back it up with the facts. He would know. His deals when he was at Palace in January kept them up. Patrick Van Aanholt, Jeffrey Schlupp, Mamadou Sakho, yeah. They kept Palace up. Before that, at Sunderland with Kone, Kirchhoff, Kasri, they kept Sunderland up with those deals as well. And I think that if he's targeted this striker, he is going to be the right player. And if West Brom stay up, I think that he will be key for them. I think he will be key for them. He will really help Sam Allardyce to try to keep West Brom up this season. So they are our picks.